So worldwide, about 9 million acres are covered in greenhouse vegetable production, and that's roughly the size, two times of New Jersey. So that's a considerable amount. So we could save an awful lot of climate-changing greenhouse gas emissions if that electricity was generated on site. A solar greenhouse is a dual-use facility. It can be used for growing plants like a regular greenhouse, but it also generates its own electricity. That electricity is then used to support the functions of the greenhouse. We've grown a variety of different crops, many of which are important to the Central Coastal region around UC Santa Cruz, including strawberries, tomatoes, lettuce. But in this study, we found that most species grew just fine under the altered light conditions. Well, the growth of tomatoes and the number of tomatoes was pretty much the same under the pink-colored glasshouse compared to a clear conventional glasshouse. This technology was developed by Professors Sue Carter and Glenn Ahlers of the Department of Physics here at UC Santa Cruz. So the color of these is because of the dye that's embedded in the windows, and the dye absorbs part of the sunlight and delivers it to thin photovoltaic strips that are embedded in the plastic, and that's where the electricity is actually generated. The visible wavelengths of sunlight include all the colors of the spectrum. These panels absorb the green, which plants don't use, and part of the blue, and that's part of why we weren't sure how plants would grow and develop, because plants like blue light and they like red light. When we measured photosynthesis, we also get a measurement of how much water the plants are using. And we find actually that they use about 5% less water when they're grown under the pink glasshouses. And if you multiply that times 9 million acres globally, that's a potential huge amount of water savings.